And I then left and went to security job. Like I tell you, I could do 3 or 4 or 6 jobs if you let me, you know? And so I heard a phone, my phone rang, so I sneak behind her. I said, what happened? I said, girl, it's 2 a.m. in the morning, girl, what you call me for? She said, you won't believe it. I said, believe what? She said, you won't believe it. I said, believe what? I said, man, what I won't believe? She said, I was crowned queen. I was crowned a queen. Amen. And guess what she said? She said, mommy, I can tell you just what she said. She said, there was white, the train them hair licked the ground. She said, that makeup was flawless. Their nails was done. I said, but you did your nails though. Oh, no, she said, I had time for that. I said, but baby, this kid is pretty. It's the prettiest. I mean, that's a color I got, that last bit. Oh, that baby's pretty. So Jose said, I said, but girl, I know you're pretty. Said, you put on your makeup. I ain't got time to put on no makeup. I said, oh God, that's before she tell me when she went. And she was telling me how fine that the children left because I teach my children how to bless others and pump up others. More highly than themselves. You know, people go, oh, I was the best. No, man, don't train your children like that. Always esteem another, higher than yourself. Amen. So she's saying how fabulous all the places looking. Give them the accolades and saying how good they look. How good they look. And then I was getting scared. I said, well, what? Because she said, guess who won crown queen? Then she said, I said, so I know, I told she, I give her the money, cheapskate, to do her hair. I said, but I know you did your hair. Oh, no, I do my hair. I said, oh my God, they do weird looking bustle then. Then all of a sudden, she said, mommy, one thing did it. She said, when I step in that dress, she said, the judges were saying, oh my God, what a dress. Now they think I pay $1,000 for the dress. They say, everybody, how much your mother pay? Where she buy this from? Oh, I don't know your dad's mommy. I don't know your dad's mommy. The judges, oh my God, Josette, that dress, whoa, you look, you know, the judges ain't supposed to say you look fabulous before the contest starts. Wow and wow and wow. So she still said, but I ain't got all these extra. Let me tell you something, you don't have to do no extra, just live holy, live consecrated life, be faithful to the woman of man of God, be a Simon. Be a Simon. No matter what somebody says, what you can't pass a woman by for, what you can't about for, I'm a Simon. A Simon render Simon to their masters. These are our masters. These are our masters that God has given us. These are the shepherds that God has given to us. We have to be glad to serve us. We have to call them. Is there anything I can do? There's an errand I can run. Is there children I can pick out? They might need, not, you know, they're rich, you know, so they might need a little couple of dollars, you know. They might need that, you know, they might take my money. But I sure got some services I could do. There is something that you can find that you can do to bless the man and woman God, to make it easier that he can bring forth the word of God. And I just want to say for real, in conclusion, I'm really going to take my seat. Let me tell you something. When my daughter told me that, the first thing I said to her, she said, mommy, with nothing on. Isn't that something? With nothing on! Let me listen, when the favor of God is on your life, honey, you get picked from the front to the back. Somebody will come ahead of you and say, I hear you're getting some freebies. And they say no. As that person turn around and you end up, they calling you. Girl, I got this, I got that. You got a team, so they say, where you get them stuff from? Oh, I just ran in there. What time are you going? 10? What? I just leave with there 10 minutes and they say they had no more. They might have no more for you, but they were waiting on me. They're waiting on you. Let's get in line. Let's line up. Let's join forces. Let's hold hands together. Let's do this work. Higher heights and deeper depths. Let's go further than when we are. You see the building? Let's go further. $300. Sometimes I give, and I started off. When I went to that ministry, let me just say, they wasn't even giving for his fruit. For his paycheck. Somebody said, child, you must be kidding me. You have to be running to give onto the building, because the building will be able to, when you house more people, you're able to serve more people and do more in the community and do stuff on a larger scale. And that's what the church is to do. We just don't want to come here with us, the same people over and over again. We want to, like the Lord wanted to do, he wanted to enlarge in your territory.
Amen.
Josette told me, said, mommy, and she normally shy. Now whom, if you hear us, the four of us, and all four of us be intercessors. So all my kids have the same gift, and they see. Josette is a seer. If she see it, you could take it all the way to what she say. Jonice is the one, if you got witchcraft, and you do, you ain't living right, don't bring her. Because she can say, uh-uh, we can't stay here. And I play crazy like, I know. She said, you don't know what they doing? I said, oh, no, I know. She said, but they don't know what they're spending time in here. Mine, she's small, you know, only 6 or 7. I said, man, couldn't, I said, well, I could just get one thing. No, we ain't spending nothing here. I had to go to the shop. The woman said, oh, come buy something. She said, Mommy, you mean you're going to spend money with them? I said, well, you know, I don't want to make a favor. She said, oh, no, their hands is not clean. And I said, she said, you didn't know that? I said, yeah, you're right. And so raise up our children to fear God. You know, you might already have grown children. You can still pray for them. It's never too late. I have a 32-year-old. I have a 26, and the baby's still in Lakeland. She's 24, moving along. And my 32-year-old daughter just moved on. Break my heart, because I always believe that you're supposed to, in order to leave your house, I believe you're supposed to marry at your house, but the Lord has to deal with me and let me know times has changed. You know, that your two kids are moving there when they're 18, they want to explore, they want to find themselves, and you have to just pray that they make the right choices and the right decisions, and they will not forget your leading and your teaching. And so we have to let them go. And it was hard for me, so I was crying. And I cried, I think, last, I started to cry, and then I said, you know what, God, I have to rely on you. If I'm crying, that's because I don't trust you. That's because I think something is going to happen. I feel like I just do something they should not. But God said, you made a mistake, and I forgive you. You made a mistake. I took you back. Remember, he said, I'm married to the backslider. So yes, our children will do some dumb things. That's not for the church to condemn them. That's not for you to condemn them. That's why children stay in the world. That's why children don't come to God. Missing your pregnant. Oh, don't sit there. Oh, no, child, she can't come to our house. Oh, our children can. That's silly. You ought to let your children be around that kid that mess up. Because that kid will mess up and tell them, baby, don't even try to come here. Don't even try to do what I do. Being sick with your parents, sneaking on the night, saying you're going to marry, you know, you're going to join. Baby, it will catch up to you. And then if you want to marry, it's a good thing. These jokers don't even want to marry no more. Because the Lord, some of them been sent on assignment to destroy our children's life and to make a shame, especially us in the ministry. And that's what I was fearful most. I have 3 daughters, 32, like I said, 26 and 24, and the 3 of them are virgins still. Because I told them, you ought to present your body as a living sacrifice, amen, holy unto God, which is your reasonable service. And when I messed up, somebody said, I wouldn't even tell my children that. When I messed up, I told them, because I want to let you know, just as you've forgiven me and loved me continuously as a mother, I want to let you know, if you mess up now, I am for you. And God is saying, we ought to be for each other. Right. That we will lose a soul. Because we're not for each other, we run to the streets and we run deep in sin. God is saying, we have to be for each other, because he's saying this morning, I am for you. My daughter said, Mommy, I began to praise the Lord with my praises. And I began to praise the Lord. And that's just supernatural. That's just for crying. But God will do silly things and natural things, because remember, it's supernatural. That means it's super, just to help of God in your natural things and situations that you need. God want to get on top of it and work it out. And so this morning I pray that you pray for me, because I'm going to Jamaica. I'm to the Outer Islands, and I tell you, I just don't like work. I love working. And so I can tell you the truth, I need your prayer, because there's a fight. God said, leave the job. I leave one, and I still holding on to two. But I'm holding on. Oh no, I got to hold on. I'm sure of this. And God said, then your faith is not totally in me. I need your faith to be totally in me. Then I would know if you really love me and trust me. Because guess what? I have nothing to go back to. But I know I have the turnpike to fall on. They love me there. They're coming, and they ask me to be supervisor. I said, I'm already a supervisor for the Lord. I'm already doing a job that I can't even, not even doing to perfection. So I can't take on any more job. So I just pray that you'll pray for me, that I just be obedient and do all that God has called me to do, because he has called me to the islands. He has sent me back home. And but 25 years even before I came here, I saw myself driving off North Park Road in Hollywood. And I said, child, please, me, the way they drive, never. I cannot live here. Now, I love the place so much. When they get home to the Bahamas, I say, oh, I gotta go home. They say, you are home. I say, no, I gotta go back home. I really love the people. And I thank God for America for allowing me to come here. Because as a foreigner, being engrafted, we ought to be grateful when God opened the door for blessing. Because my children have the choice. They can go to any school. They're very smart. We call it Junie's. Is getting ready to graduate. She's about to buy a house. And so I ain't buying no house. I say, a sport there for me? It better be. I said, girl, I done lie, I done cheat, I done steal. Man, you gotta pay me back some for all the lies. I gotta miss my way, man. Going to the food, some people say, I even didn't know your daddy. I know just what I'm honest. So since you're playing crazy, I done lie. He didn't tell you the lie. I said, but I done lie. I just won't pay him. Cause I didn't tell a lie. And we got the food, some right in here was eating. The pickle egg and the hot dog. You were all having a good time? Okay then, I need payment. So she reassured me, there's a spot for me. Y'all pray my joy in the Lord. Amen.
Come on, y'all, give people a good job. Amen. And it's okay to have somebody real in the house. Amen. I mean, she just just kept on preaching, amen. I could have stayed out of town. Amen. Watching Pastor Ida sleep. Amen. To get back to y'all to preach, amen. Now I asked Pastor, I want y'all to hear me now. I asked Pastor Penny, I said, come on, Pastor Penny, you can go ahead and preach. And she was like, nah, Pastor, nah, I'm going to give a word of encouragement. She sure did, amen. Amen. She gave words of encouragement, amen. Amen. God is good. Amen. So she's forcing me because she told me that God sent her up here because she needed to hear a message that God had birthed in me, but she didn't know what that message was. And so she told me that her assignment wasn't to come and preach, but just to assort and give you words of encouragement. Amen. Amen. So I have to give you a sermonette. Amen. Y'all know I'm going to take my time, but I'm not going to keep you long because I'm going to hit you quick with this one. Can I get a witness? Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Also, I've heard some good news at the end. I'll be dealing with that. Amen. Concerning some good news. But if you would join me in 2 Samuel, amen. We're just going to jump real quick. Amen. Amen. It's 12:09. Amen. I'm not watching the time. I'm just watching the hour. Amen. Just watching the hour. I don't want to keep you long, but I want to make sure, amen, that I birthed in you the confirmation in the course. And we haven't, Pastor Peter, we haven't talked, right?
No.
We haven't discussed any of this. Amen. Can somebody know that? Amen. Let the Spirit talk, amen. Let the Spirit does what the Spirit do, amen. Amen. Tell your neighbor, say, after this message, I will be different. Can I get a witness? Amen. Amen. After this message, I will be different. Amen. I'll be different. Amen. Because today I believe, amen, if you receive what I believe that God has poured in to me and Pastor Ida, even this weekend, amen, it is awesome. 2 Samuel, the 9th chapter, amen. This weekend, we got away, amen. Yes, it was my birthday, amen, and we went down and we got away, amen. But I was more happy on my birthday to see my family. Amen. What I'm saying with my brothers and sisters, just to be around them, because it's been like 30 years. Can I get a witness? Amen.
Amen.
That I departed Fayetteville, and I was there after 30 years. It was on my being. I mean, it's been 30 years. Over 30 years that I have been gone and was able to see some things. Amen. But I just want to share with you, amen, real quickly, amen, something that has been birthed in my spirit that I need for us to get a hold for, amen. Very long verse, amen. But I'm just going to ask y'all to just quickly stand with me just to get through this, amen. Because I want you to see something that is very powerful. 2 Samuel, the 9th chapter, starting at the first verse, amen. And David says, is there yet any that is left of the house of Saul that I may show him kindness? That's another preach on just right there. That I may show him kindness for Jonathan's sake. And there was a house of Saul, a servant whose name was Ziba. And when he called him unto David, the king said unto him, art thou Ziba? And he says, thy servant is he. And the king says, is there not yet any of the house of Saul that I may show kindness of God unto him? And Ziba said unto the king, Jonathan had yet a son, which is lame. Not a lamb, but lame. On his feet. Meaning he's unable to move on his own. Can I get a witness? Amen. And the king said unto them, where is he? And Ziba said unto the king, behold, he's in the house of Mishael, the son of Amriel, in Lo-debar. Everybody say Lo-debar. My. We're going to get to that. And then King David sent and fled him out of the house of Mishael, the son of Amriel, from Lo-debar. Now when, here he goes, Mephibosheth, the son of Jonathan, the son of Saul, which was unto David, he fell on his face and did reverence. And David says, Mephibosheth. And he answered, behold thy servant. And David said unto him, fear not, for I will surely show thee kindness for Jonathan thy father's sake, and restore thee all the land of Saul thy father. And thou shalt eat bread at my table continuously. And he bowed himself and says, what is it, thy servant, that thou should look upon such a dead dog as I am? Oh, my. Then the king called his servant and Saul's servant and said to him, I have given unto the master's son all that pertained to Saul and all to his house. Come on and tell your neighbors, say neighbors. God has not forgotten about you. Can I get a witness? Come on, give a praise, clap, and a hug. Amen. Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, God has not forgotten about you. Amen. Amen. God has not forgotten about you. Amen. Amen. Father, we do thank you for this time and this moment as we go forth, Father. We just thank you, Father, that as you would go to already intercede and enter on our behalf, Father, we just thank you, God, that you have already spoken it, Father, and that you have already allowed us to move forth, Father. And Father, we can thank you, right? Because, God, the way that we came out and it's not the way that we are right now, God, you don't even see any of it. So, God, we're going to thank you right now. We're going to glorify you, and we're going to magnify you. Come on, give somebody a praise, five, and a hug, and let them know again, God has not forgotten you. Can I get a witness? Amen. 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 As we start to look at the text, amen, I'm just going to be, come on, musicians, I need y'all up here, amen. We're going to be quick, amen. And as you start to look at the text, amen, one of the key things as you start to follow this, amen, is that David has just came out of war, amen. And it's in the transitioning, amen, to where David is trying to bring all of Israel together, elder. Y'all see what I'm saying? Amen. And in the midst of this, amen, you will find out that this is after, amen, that Saul and Jonathan's and Saul's sons, amen, has been killed in the battle, amen. In 1 Samuel, I think it's 31, the last chapter, amen, is where Saul falls, amen. In 2 Samuel is when David starts to come in and take over. Can I get a witness? Amen. And as you start to look at this text, amen, and you start to follow it, it makes you try to understand, well, wait a minute, amen, he's coming out of battle, but after coming out of battle, he wants to show kindness unto, amen, a family that did not receive him, amen. Saul never received him because when it was announced that he was the king, Saul refused to receive that. But somebody say Jonathan. But Jonathan understood, amen, that regardless of what his father saw or did not see, he realized
And as you go through the text, you will find out that Jonathan and David was like best friends. Can I get a witness? Amen. Amen. Jonathan did not see David as a replacement of Herod to the throne. He saw him as a friend of Christ. Can I get a witness? Amen. I'm not going to be long, amen, because as you start to get the understanding, amen, it bothered David when he was aware of what had happened, amen. But watch this. Even though something bad happened, that don't mean you have to come down to it.
Amen.
Can I get a witness, amen? And so as you start to follow the text, amen, you start to understand, amen, that wait a minute, as you go back, amen, into 2 Samuel 4, amen, you will find out, amen, that Jonathan's son, Mephibosheth, amen, you will find out that what happened was to him, amen. Somebody say, just because something happened does not mean it needs to stay. Y'all might help me, amen, amen. Because I'm going to let you know, see, because as you see the lamb part, that he's lamb, meaning no movements, amen. Not a lamb, but lame, amen. You will see that there's no movements, amen. And he's in a place, amen, that when you see it, you see that place is a place of pathless, meaning pastureless. And when it talked about that, he was in what was the place? Oh, Lodi Bar, amen. Lodi Bar itself, Jeff, is a place of pastureless, meaning there ain't no favor here.
No.
Meaning all the condition is the same. It's the same condition as if you found with that stinking seed, amen. I'm drawing a blank, amen. What is leprosy, amen? They would cast you out, amen. Meaning your life is no longer an acknowledgement or has a purpose with them. Lodi Bar. Meaning no favor is there. It's already this thing, someone, can I get a witness, amen? Amen. This thing's already been settled.
Yes.
Can I get a witness, amen?
Amen?
See, sometimes we have some things go on with us and we believe it's already been settled. Amen. And we're going to have to live with this for the rest of our life. Amen. Because here it is, we're thinking God has forgotten about us. That the condition is more important than his blessing. And I will ride that condition. Can I get a situation? Amen. I will ride that circumstance. I will ride it out because God's already aware of it. And it's up to him to change it. Can I get a witness? Amen. See, God hasn't forgotten about you because as you start to look at this, amen, you will see that David, let me just go back just for a second, amen. You got to understand that Jonathan's son, amen, was a perfect little boy at the age of 5. And if you go back to Second Samuel 4:4, you will find out what happened, Sister Agnes, amen, is when the nurse got the news. She was fleeing with him to get him to safety, to get him to a place to where he wouldn't die. And he failed while she was trying to get him to a place. And because of the fall, he became paralyzed, disillusioned. Nothing is perfect anymore. Anybody know what it's like to be in a wheelchair? Will you bring that to me for a second, Elder? See, when we see a wheelchair, y'all help me preach this, amen.
Amen.
See, when we see a wheelchair, amen, it puts a mindset on us, amen, that this is a hell. We believe that this is what God has said. This is his help to us, amen, because he can't help me anymore, so he's going to send something to help me. And so what I end up doing, I become dependable on this. Y'all don't want to talk to me, amen, amen. And as long as you can push me around, and as long as you can get me around, amen, I feel like I'm still moving. Because God, it looks like he's forgotten about me, amen. Because why would he leave me in a wheelchair? Y'all better come on and help me, amen. Why would he leave me in this condition? Why would he let that circumstance stay the way it is? Why would he let my finances be jacked up like that, amen? Just because you're in a wheelchair, just because something is going on, does not mean God has
left you. You got to be bigger than the situation. So if you end up in a wheelchair and God sends somebody to push you because you can't push yourself, can I get a witness? Amen. You ought to appreciate you're still living. But what they did, amen, his condition became so bad, Sister Agnes, that they put him over in Lodibar. In other words, they gonna put him over here in a section called cast out. Y'all don't want to talk to me, amen. Why? Because they don't want that vision, amen. They don't want that struggle on the people, amen. And ain't it amazing, amen, that when something goes on, amen, everybody want to put us out when we need to be in. Can I get a witness, amen? Amen. Everybody want to put us out, amen. They don't want to know, right? They don't want us to know what happened, amen. Let me help somebody real quick. Everybody look at me for a second. You got to stop letting people handle you the wrong way. And on top of that, you got to stop handling yourself the wrong way.
Yes, that's right.
Because a lot of our issues and problems is based off who has handled us or mishandled us in our life. And sometimes we don't know how to let that go ourselves. So we mishandle ourselves to try to impress ourselves. And we actually end up missing it. Because it wasn't that he, can I get a witness, amen? He wasn't born that way. Can I get a witness, amen?
That's true.
He ended up that way.
Yes, yes.
Anybody understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
See, sometimes we have children, they're born 1 pound, 2 pounds, or they're, and the doctor said, we don't know if they're gonna make it. They don't have that decision. When you know God's got that decision, you are able to pray like you never prayed before. Because your child's going to make it because God put him here.
Yes,
you're going to make it because God put you here. No matter what you go through. If you end up in a wheelchair, that doesn't mean he's finished with you. Can I get a witness? Somebody say God hasn't forgotten. You know, and in the text, it starts to tell us, amen. Y'all come on, musician, give me some organ and some backup here in a second. I'm gonna take off here. I can't be long, amen. I gotta get them out of here, amen. But what ends up happening, amen, is David, he calls for somebody that he can show love and kindness to.
Yeah.
Not that he forgot, but he just wanted to know, was there anybody left in that situation? Can I get a witness here? Was there anybody that was still in that situation to where I could just show, how many people, you just wish they could show love and kindness. But because they're so stuck on themselves, amen, they believe their love for you is so important that you got to receive it even though they're giving it to you negative. Can I get a witness? Amen.
Amen.
They believe every comment that comes out of their mouth is profound and anointed, but yet the fruit don't come with it.
Amen.
And they're asking you to walk in something, to carry something, only because it came from them. And they want you to know, I got this. No, you don't. God has not forgotten you.
Amen.
And so we see it, amen, that what David started to do, amen, David started to do, Pastor Adam, he says, is there anyone that is left that I may show kindness? Tap your neighbor and say, I got to change. Amen. I got to show kindness. Amen. Amen. I'm telling you, amen. You can say whatever you want to say. Amen. But if you can't show kindness, amen, then God is not in you. Amen. Not the way he needs to be in you. Not flowing the way he ought to flow in you. Amen. Because love is kindness. Can I get a witness? Amen.
Amen.
And so as we start to see this, amen, he sends for him, and the servant goes and get him. Amen. And as he goes to get him, Elder, would you get the table for me first? Amen. And we're gonna, because the key behind it, amen, is that David
wanted to bring somebody to the King's table. Can I get a witness? Amen. Yeah. Not just to any table, Elder Angela, but to the what? King's table. Amen. Yeah. Because it's important to come to the King's table, yeah, than just going to somebody else's table. How many of us know we keep going to the other table instead of coming to the King's table? Because when we get to the King's table, it's God's word at the table, amen? We keep on picking up everybody else's table, trying to get a word about the King at their table, and they ain't talking about the King. But yet we stay there. Be satisfied with what they said at their table. And we're trying to figure out what's going on, because God has not forgotten you. And the key about it is that he's lame. Not lame, like lame. And then when he's lame, gay, amen, means somebody needs to help him, Jacob. Can somebody say, I need some help, amen? See, that's what happened with a lot of Christians, amen. Amen. You get so Christified, amen, that you believe that only your help coming from the Lord. So God can't send nobody else. Because you won't receive who God sends, because unless you got it, you understand it, it didn't come from God. And yet God talks about many members of one body. He said he gave some, and we trying to be all that. And we're missing it. Because it's all about me. It's my gift. If you got to prove your gifts, you're walking in error. If you got to prove your gifts, you're walking in error. And you're going to bring it set up to yourself. The Bible says it will bear witness to itself. Amen. Sometimes God don't need you to show your gift. And so you're forcing to show your gift, and God ain't telling you to show your gift. You're out of order.
Amen.
And so as we start to see this, amen. Elder, come help me, amen. So he sends for him, and the servant comes and get him, amen. And gang, you got to watch this, amen. And let me tell y'all something. I'm not speaking nothing negative on my life. So if you see negativity, that's your fault.
Amen.
But sometimes I need help.
Yeah.
Sometimes I can't get to the table.
Yeah.
Because while he's trying to get me to the table, I don't want to go to the table. Can I get a witness, amen? Amen. I'll rock, amen. I'll stop, amen. Because God's trying to get me to the table. But I refuse to get to the table because I'm still upset about what happened, amen. Because I ain't got no control, amen. But I'm still upset about getting to the table, amen. And I'm going to force God not to get me to the table. Because I know if I get to the table, amen, my help coming from the Lord, amen. I'm still mad about what happened with mommy. I'm still mad about what happened with daddy. I'm still mad about what happened with my children, amen. I'm still mad about what happened. And now I push back on God, amen. Because I'm so upset why he's trying to get me to the table. Because if God can get me to the table, amen, the table, amen, where my help coming from. Some of us, when we get to the table, amen, we don't want to be at the table. Come on, we'll push me, man. We going to kick the table, amen. We going to push the table, amen. We going to get the table. We going to knock the table over because we want to do it ourselves.
Yeah.
And ain't it amazing? God, pick it back up.
Yeah.
Set it back up.
Yeah.
He'll pick it back up. And he'll set it back up. And so we're going to do this again. We're going to, now if you don't want to get there, that's your problem. But what I want to show you is God has not forgotten you. So in Melchizedek, well, his name, John the Son, amen.
Go ahead.
When he was getting, he realized, amen, I'm a dead dog.
Uh-huh.
But yet God's trying to bless me.
Amen.
Ain't no reason why I should be getting blessed. But God says, just get him to the table. See, because getting to the table, you watch my legs.
Yeah, yeah.
And my legs ain't got no control. But if I can just get to the Father's table, can I get a witness?
Yeah.
And as I get to the table, turn it just a little bit. Amen. There you go. And I get my legs under the table. And I'm at the King's table. Can I get a witness? Amen.
Yeah.
Now you see me different. Because you can't see my condition no more. Now you see me different. Because you can't watch me no more. All you can see is the top now. All you can do is hear what I'm saying now. All you can do is I'm praising him and blessing him right now. When you get to the table, God's going to bless you. Amen. Don't fight to get to the table. Don't fight not to be at the table. Don't fight the table. Stop fighting yourself. Just get to the table. Why? Because at the table,
yes, yes,
is his word.
Yes. Thank you,
God. Can I get a witness, Elder? Will you go ahead and grab that album? Because if I get to the table, he says he prepared a table in the presence of my enemy. And when I understand this and I get a hold of this, amen, I know I can't move. I know my legs don't give me what I'm supposed to do and they don't do what it's doing. But then I realize I wasn't born this way. And if I learned to trust God, God would turn this thing around regardless of my condition. Can I get a witness? Amen. Regardless of what I'm going through, regardless of what I've been through, come on, Pat, I need y'all to help me. Amen. Because I know God is able. Amen. And that's why God says, even if your legs don't work, if you just take a moment to trust me, I can put back in you what man took out you. I can give you what man can't give you, amen. I can do what man can't do, amen. I can bless you what man can't touch you, amen. Why? When you get to the table is prepared. It's in the presence of the Lord. And you realize God is able to do all things. As a matter of fact, the table becomes so good, amen, that all you want to do is carry the table wherever you go. Come on, we help me, amen. Let me show y'all what you do, man. Amen. No, no, no. We'll get behind you. Help me, man. Amen. Watch this. This is what God do. I change the table with you. Can I get a witness? Amen. It's time to remember, saints. God has not forgotten you. He has not forgotten. He has not forgotten. Just get to the table. All it took for Jonathan's son was to get back to the table. And the whole house of Saul were blessed for three reasons. Then I'm gonna close, amen. Three reasons. Will pass me that notebook real quick, amen. Thank you, sir. Amen. There was three reasons that David was able to show kindness. The reason that David was able to show kindness for the first reason was because he desired to have, watch this, covenant. You got that desire to have covenant with God. Can I get a witness? Amen. Yeah. Number two, amen. David showed compassion. Can I get a witness? Amen. David didn't get caught up on himself. He didn't get caught up on himself. He realized he still has enough in him to show compassion even through the situation that he was in. That he was willing to, watch this. David could have blessed anybody, but he went to the lowest of the Lord. He said, if he's in lowly bar, go get him. Go get him. I'm going to show kindness to him. I'm going to show covenant for his father's sake. And as you follow that through, he says for Jonathan's sake, but the truth be told, because he had Jesus, he could show compassion. Are y'all hear what I'm saying? Amen. And then David showed, he says, now I'm going to give you covering. Not only am I going to put you in a position, but I'm going to restore everything that has been taken from you. Everything to the house of Saul, the king that just died, and everything that was taken, I restore it to the house of Saul. And all that was for a grandson that was lame. He had given up on himself, but God had not given up on him. Can I get a witness? Amen.
Amen.
Saints, all I want to tell you is that we can go home. Just get to the table. God has not forgotten about you. Can I get a witness? Amen. Come on, tell your neighbor, say, God ain't forgotten about you. He ain't forgotten about you. Amen. He know how you act. He know how you carry yourself. You don't have to be hurt all your life. You don't have to be in charge all your life. But if you ever learn to trust God, you would know He has not forgotten about you. I'm speaking to dreams of dreams right now. I'm speaking to desires of desires right now. I'm speaking to needs of needs right now. God hasn't forgotten you. Can I get somebody to help me? God hasn't forgotten you. He don't want your ways. It's His ways. He don't want your ways. He already got a word. He don't want your will. He said, let that will be done. It's His will.
Yes, yes.
But God has not forgotten you. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
And if He ain't forgot you, He ain't forgot your kids.
Amen.
He ain't forgot your situation.
Amen.
He ain't forgot your circumstances.
Yes.
God has not forgotten you. And in the midst where you think you're out there by yourself because somebody handled you wrong, somebody did you wrong, or you did yourself wrong, but you just won't admit it, God has not forgotten you. Is that all right? Take your table with your saints. Don't let it be temporary. Let it be permanent. If He said He prepares a table in the presence of your enemy, stop being an enemy. Get yourself together. Know that God has you. Heads bowed, eyes closed. Come on, let's lift your hands. Pray with me now. Hallelujah.